Melanie. I am back with another, I guess, transformation. I don't know what else to call this. I did a video recently where I showed the homeschool space for our kids. And I got a couple questions about how to do a homeschool space for older kids or for college students. So I tried to create that. Welcome to our little homework corner. I tried to pick stuff out that I would really like when I was in college or in high school. And these are things I like now, obviously, because I purchased them. But yeah, I tried to go with like a gray theme. You, of course, could do something different. I want to say, not including this thing and this thing, I spent definitely under 50, 100% under. I might even have spent 50 including this thing at the bottom. But anyway, I'm just going to show you guys what I did. I do want to point out that this is just in a corner because our last transformation was in a closet. Plenty of people said they didn't have space in a closet. And nothing is on the wall because I know if you're in a dorm room, you might not be able to do that, things like that. So I went ahead and kept that in mind. And everything's on a shoestring budget because that's the way I like things. I like to DIY them, you know, and buy stuff that is definitely less expensive, and then you can just make it look better. You know what I mean? Anyway, here's the video. Please stay, please subscribe, and please like. All right, video. Alrighty, that's my cute little daughter in frame. Anyway, the first thing I did was I got a desk, really inexpensive, from IKEA. You buy the legs and the top. That's like the smallest top I think they had. And I fit a cube shelf underneath. They're, you know, trendy. You guys know how that is. Inexpensive. And then the bins are actually from holler.com. You can buy them, you know, anywhere. Holler.com has them, really inexpensive. You could put all kinds of stuff in there. I mean, six bins under that little tiny desk. And then there's room for binders. I thought that was really super cool. So if you have any blank space, definitely shove books in there. Anyway, this lamp, I love it. I have quite a few in my living room. It was from IKEA. You buy the base and the top, and it was like less than $15 total. The paper holder thingies, what are these even called, you guys? They probably have a name. Anyway, the paper holders, for lack of whatever term they are, they're four for a dollar and they're cardboard. I was hesitant to buy them when I bought a pack last year. And they made it through a whole entire year, and my son's in kindergarten and they didn't fall apart. So I bought more for other things around the house. So I figured it'd be perfect, you know, for anybody that has a school space that wants to like be more organized. Anyway, I decided to put them up against the wall back to back to save more space. You can always, you know, organize them however you want to, or put them on a bookshelf. But to show that I can put it all on one desk, I decided to put it off to the side. I think it worked out pretty well. The next thing I did was get this crate. It's from Michael's. You can use a coupon. I just painted it gray. I might sand it down a little bit. And I also got this chalkboard. Notice I'm leaning it up against to add some height, and you can write your notes on it. You don't have to actually hang it on the wall, or you can use a command hook, whatever you want. By the way, subscribe. Anyway, I also got that with the coupon from Michael's. Now this clear, these come in like, they're 50 cents during back to school season. These like clear or any color you want, really. Cases, like pencil cases, you can put all kinds of stuff in there. Your flashcards, whatever you want. And then I got a couple more little detail things that were on clearance at Michael's. Check Michael's clearance for stuff like this because it's so inexpensive. I added a pencil cup. I didn't really know where I wanted to put it. I ended up putting it outside of the crate. I actually, looking back, think it looks better inside the crate. This was 50 cents on holler.com. You can buy it for a dollar at Dollar Tree. You guys know how that is. This little guy was on clearance for like, I don't know, $2 at Michael's also. Maybe it's a little redundant with the two S's, but I like that stuff. So I went ahead and did that. I have a map placemat I just happened to have, and it's gray on one side. So I thought that was pretty cool. You know, to like add something to the space, you totally don't have to. And then a clipboard, because I recommend clipboards all the time for travel or just to do your work, like on your bed or whatever you want to do. The chair, by the way, super inexpensive. I think it was like under $10 at IKEA. It's not a desk chair. You might want to add like a, you know, a cushion or whatever. Super easy peasy. And that is it. This is literally, I think the tabletop for this at IKEA was like $8 and each leg was $4. So I'm not exactly sure on that total. I may have to check for you. But anyway, the point is it's all grayscale. You can literally buy anything from Michael's and paint it gray. They have a lot of stuff on clearance. And remember, if you have any spaces left, like you can see the binder in there,
just shove stuff, you know, anywhere it'll fit. I totally still do that because I have a 1,000 square foot home because I'm all about small living. Anyway, and the rolling carts. We have a couple of these. We use them in the kitchen, homeschool, things like that. I actually homeschool young children, but this is just a point. You know, I wish they had these when I was in college or when I got my first apartment because I love mine in all rooms of my house. But anyway, that's the way it turned out. I actually really like it. I think you can, you know, literally do it any color scheme that you wanted to, and it was extremely inexpensive, you know, to achieve the look.
Guys, so that is it. Please stay and subscribe and for DIYs every week, by the way. Give this video a thumbs up, and that is it. All right, thank you guys for watching. It means the world to me. Bye, y'all. Love Yinz. Have fun at school.